Thank you. Happy Sabbath to you all.
Happy
Sabbath to you all.
Happy
and thank the Lord for another Sabbath. It is my belief that what the Lord has for all of us, we will have it this afternoon. It's good to meet you once again. Last week, others were not here. We were in retreat. By God's grace, we came successfully.
The
retreat was quite okay. Once again, I welcome you to this special service.
Yes, pray,
Mr.
Tesla,
just come down here. I welcome all of you to today's service. The whole of this year, the topic for the conference or the theme for the conference is reclamation.
And then, as I feel, you know, conference, the chief only said, "You go to Oma Accra, I am Abba."
And the Southwest Church have divided our reclamation into four parts.
They are subdued. The chief more and the chapel and nine so.
The first quarter we are dealing with knowing Christ.
Then it kind of say, "You yes."
And it will follow up until we do the main reclamation. Today we are going to talk about Jesus Christ being the spiritual law giver.
And there are
however, I have titled the sermon, "It's Time to Listen and Obey."
And so Makan Kasoko said,
Southwest and the members of the church, it is time we listen and we obey. Indeed, if we want to know God more, then it is time for we to listen to Him and obey Him. Shall we have a word of prayer?
We will pray.
In this prayer, I want Amar to rise up and pray for us as we stand at the divine service. Amar, can you rise up and pray for us? It is time to listen and obey. Every country in the world today once have a constitution or a bylaws that governs that country. These bylaws that governs every country has their main base from the Ten Commandments, which is found in Exodus chapter 20. Whether the country is a democratic ruling or autocratic ruling, they have their base from the constitution from the Ten Commandments. And these laws or this constitution are made for the order of the country, the harmony and the fairness of the society. But sometimes some of the countries, because of the governance parochial interest, they try sometimes in doing their constitution, trying to put some immunities so that they are not fined wanting at the end of the day.
Now, I thought that, and I'm saying, if you have been paying for them, or come on,
constitution of a country is made for the people to follow so that at least the citizens will be very happy. Ghana's constitution in 1992, in the Fourth Republic. When the constitutional frame workers were actually bringing this constitution together. Because of some of the incumbent government parochial interests, they indeed put some immunities in that constitution so that some government will be set free. They will not be prosecuted when they go out.
These are
kind of the laws sometimes some of the world enact so that the people that they govern will follow.
Now when we are saying to do for a year, said they are watching the fans or maybe for no baby teaching.
When you come to corporates,
Oba also are a year human
industries.
They also have
their bylaws.
Also,
if you want to go to work in a specific company, you are called for interview. And during the interview, they give you all the bylaws of the company. If indeed you are satisfied with all the bylaws, you are employed. And wherever you are employed, you make sure that you go by the bylaws of the company. UK. They don't have a written constitution. What they don't want to do is they sit down, the House of Commons and the House of the Lords, they sit down, they enact something and they use it. They don't have
a written constitution.
Whatever comes out of the House Laws or the House of Commons discussion, whatever comes out of it when they vote it and they enact it, it becomes binding. Every citizen in Whoever go against such constitution or whoever go against such bylaws is tantamount for sanction or
punishment.
Well, at times we do have some citizens that are very stubborn. They go against such laws, but they are sanctioned.
It is
time to listen.
Do mercy and see.
And it is time to obey.
God
laws. God laws is universal. It is universal for everybody on this
earth.
God laws does not discriminate. It is for the white, it is for the black. It is for the Africans, it is for the Caribbeans, it is for the Americans. God laws does not favor a specific particular group of people. God laws are fair and just. This is a kind of law the Lord has given to his people that he has called. Anyone who has proclaimed or has declared that he is a follower of Christ must follow the laws. Yes, when you go to Ephesians, Paul said something in Ephesians that we are saved by grace through the faith of Jesus Christ. And the same Paul continued to say in Romans chapter 2 verse 12 all followers will be judged by the laws of God. So regardless of that, we are saved by grace through the faith in Jesus Christ, yet still we will be judged by the laws.
The laws
or the commandments of God became an issue before Jesus came. When Moses went for the laws, how some of the dead worshippers. Interpreted the laws became a bit of a problem to those people.
Now, yeah,
sometimes people find it even difficult to understand the way the explanation goes. Thank God that Jesus Christ came on this earth. And one of the purposes is to explain something about the laws that he gave to us. So on the mountain, on the Sermon on the Mountain, Jesus made a declaration as what exactly the spiritual
meaning
of the laws are. So after choosing the 12 disciples to witness the whole world, Jesus taught them the basic spiritual principle of what Matthew has actually recorded. And these teachings are sometimes known as the Sermon on the Mountain. This teaching, now known as the Sermon on the Mountains, were in the beginning of the New Covenant.
Now, unlike
the Old Covenant,
which
offered physical blessings,
the
New Covenant that was brought by Jesus Christ offered spiritual blessings to the So throughout the whole Bible, there are sometimes contrast between the physical and the spiritual meaning of the
laws.
But Paul explains something to us. In 1 Corinthians chapter 5, 15:45-47, the word of Paul shows that physical comes first. The physical law which was brought by Moses was the first that day. So Paul talked about Adam, the first man on this earth. Came from earth. And he was a spiritual and he was a physical. He also spoke about Jesus Christ, who also came from heaven. And he was also the spiritual
lawgiver.
In likeless manner, the old covenant, which was physical, was established before the new covenant, which is spiritual. Moses, who was a mediator, and the law, physical lawgiver, became the new spiritual lawgiver as Jesus Christ. So when the children of Israel, when they were about to enter the promised land, God gave them Moses this prophecy of the coming
Messiah.
And I read from Deuteronomy chapter 18. Here says the Lord. And the Lord said to me, they have spoken well. What they have spoken, that they did not want God to speak to them, but Moses. I will raise them up a prophet from among their brethren, one like you, and will put my words in his mouth. And he shall speak, then all shall I command to him.
And no, then Rade catch him there, he said, dear, what can you, what can you eat? Mama, would you for so much my woman and your new self? Now, may they make some, they share number. Now, I can't dear, my share in our actual. Amen.
We are trying to deal with the laws that were given by Moses.
Yeah, come, Moses, Brad, I made the man also.
And how difficult the then Christians were. So when Jesus came, Jesus came to explain, to expand, and to magnify the laws that were given by Moses. Some of the explanations revelation Jesus gave also could not reach the understanding of some of the people.
Now, Jesus church will come and give them answers.
Who was then Jesus?
Now, Jesus
to give such an explanation.
Now, no one said or this are church will ever.
I come back to the old covenant. The old covenant which requires obedience to the letter of the law, the new covenant is based on obedience.
Now, can you know that the Ubuswa, the one that now is a car was okay? There's a get here in a city, oh, yeah, I'm ready.
Jesus Christ came as a spiritual lawgiver to amplify, to magnify the commandments of God so that we will be well versed of understanding it.
Yes, you buy the Bible, but we should move on. But no. Let me actually demand. Let me ask you.
As a spiritual leader,
yes, you are not your own penino.
Jesus revealed a full meaning of the laws. He received a commission from the Father to preach the gospel and proclaim the spiritual meaning of the commandments of God. In order to bring knowledge of salvation to the people. So throughout Jesus' ministry, Jesus taught repentance. Repentance from sin, which is clearly defined in the New Testament as transgression.
Ah, what did you say? Sir, only we be etched, and as a we be etched.
The gospel accounts believe that God needs requires obedience to his commandment, not only just looking at the laws, but requirement of obedience.
Now, about who for me, we say, and yes, I can kind of any one, and just say, you know, so they will, you suit me a final, acting a brand or a senior.
Yes, we can be Adventists today.
I will try and be a foreign idea.
It is true that everybody knows that we believe in Jesus. But the question now comes, how do you obey the instructions of Jesus that you want to follow?
And then that's what I say, it's not teaching. I've come back now, first of all, 18 years.
When we heard the reading from James chapter 2 verse 10, James made it very clear that if indeed the laws are many and you commit one, it's
going to be completed also.
So brethren, I want to advise you this morning. Do not be proud of yourself.
And then there was somebody and said,
he's trying to make some of the laws inferior.
And many who are good
and make some of them so big.
No, I am so kind of calm.
So those who don't commit fornication in the church, they are the righteous. So if you commit fornication, you are from Satan. What kind of understanding is that?
And then,
let us be very careful. Indeed, if we say we believe in the one who has called us, then it behoves on us to make sure that we follow his footsteps. Jesus never came to destroy the law.
Yes, you have a sermon.
He came rather to magnify it.
No, but shame.
He came to make sure that people will get understanding of the law. There is no way that when we believe in Jesus Christ, it means the laws are abandoned. In John chapter 14, verse 15,
you heard us,
the Bible says, if you love me, abide by my commandments. We are sitting down here telling everybody that we love Jesus. Do we indeed abide by your commandments? A doctor went to Jesus.
Oh, yeah, for me, I'll call Jesus.
And ask Jesus.
Who said Jesus?
Which of the laws is the greatest?
Or say, remember the other one I can say.
And Jesus said to him,
or say, okay, not to share.
Love!
Or say, God.
Love yourself.
Oh.
Love your neighbor.
I know your call.
Love Jesus Christ.
I know Jesus.
So when he heard it,
not
he thought that was all.
Or say, no,
but to love your neighbor, to love God.
Or say, well, God.
You cannot proclaim to love God when you disobey Him.
Only that's how you are now when the wouldn't see the outcome.
It doesn't work like that.
There's going
to be a judgment.
Tell me about that.
Judgment is coming.
Tell me about.
And God is going to judge us by the law.
I'm going to man, you want to saw and I'm
He will never go aside the law to judge us.
And then of all you man to change, now we attend.
Be careful of the kind of life you live. Let us be very careful.
Yeah, right.
His judgment is just.
He
is impartial. He will judge you according to what you have done.
You will just be able to attend.
In the middle of 90s.
I feel I can handle no one.
I had some trucks which were going to Togo bringing some stuff. One day when my driver was driving from Kumasi to, he was going to Livé. He had an accident on the road. Somebody's car, Benz, just crossing, and that was it, crashed
the Benz.
I had to run to Kibi to make sure that everything is done properly. When I went to Kibi police station, after the investigation, it was found out that actually the fault was from the private man. It wasn't from my driver. So we understood ourselves that, okay, the man will take his car away and I'll also take my truck back. I'm talking about the impartial of God when it comes to judgment by the law.
Brethren,
it is time we listen and we obey. Look, we cannot be playing God anymore. We
can
listen to Him. We
can
obey God. We cannot be like this all the time. Jesus is coming. He's going to change us. Very soon. Jesus. You can't bribe Him. Jesus will not take silly into his pocket. But the candidate of this man. So we settled the matter at Kibi. Not knowing the man had an
ulterior motive.
I went back to Accra and I had information that the man has taken the case to court. So I have to quickly come back to Kumasi and make sure that we go to the court. The man has come to speak to the police and make sure that the docket that they were presenting to the court was going to be against me.
My brother.
Now listen to the way people, the judges, look at the way they judge by the law that is enacted by the country's government.
Now we have you
and compare it to God's one.
So the case went to court in Kumasi.
And there was a belief in that court. A belief is those guys who the court sent to go and give letters. There was one guy who worked there. So he came quickly to my house, White House, and said, Uncle Joe, look, your case is coming up so. The docket has come to us. The man has filed against your driver. If you don't take care, they will put your driver in prison. And I said, Then after saying that to me, look at the kind of judgment. After saying that to me, Uncle Joe, do you know what you can do? And I said, what?
I said, yeah.
To get where you see the church.
I said, okay, Umunu, they will go at him.
To go and see the church?
I said, I don't know Umunu.
When the priest took it, he said to me that my driver is not at fault.
The brother, please, like I said, my driver, no money for him.
Okay, that's fine. Let's go.
I said, yeah, uncle.
So he sat in my car and I drove to Asuka. That was where the church was living.
Yeah, cool.
We went there.
I think we just for what?
He went, he knocked the door.
See, for
then the man, big man with the big sword, he came.
But my man can say, but so
he sat down. He asked my name.
He said,
why do you live?
I said, hey,
I live, but
so it's
a who's your dad?
Oh, Papa,
and I said, Puku Ajiman.
So Puku Ajiman.
And I described my dad.
What
I
mean,
it's your dad.
Oh, Papa,
Puku Ajiman.
Sir,
your dad is my friend.
Oh, hey, my dad, Papa.
Thank you, God.
Yes.
Never knew there was something behind.
You said there will be a church.
The child was my father's friend.
Oh, your papa had done for.
So I knew that it was quite okay.
So then I had a book.
I left the house. And as I stepped going out,
the brother will see about
the man called me back.
As a friend.
Listen to a kind of death.
Compared
to Jesus' one.
The brother is the other tongue.
The one who says my dad was his friend.
Or say, yeah, papa had done for you. I say,
hey, Leba, who can't send it from Papa Neko?
Man, your car
runs
from Accra Road to and fro.
Accra Road, no more car. Yeah, no more. Or train, you see, any car.
You see, if they sell push feet along the roadside,
who come there to bring it?
When you have some bicycle.
I couldn't believe what I was trying to say.
Okay, no,
so I left the house with the belief.
See, when they don't look like that, you know.
The guy said to me, if you look at the way the police has prepared the docket,
so who said it? Please follow, and I did, and somebody by the day.
You're not careful.
So what we are?
The case will go against you.
So
you have to listen to what the man has said.
They walk out and fire
you. Then I said to the guy,
so we can share and say,
me Adventist,
me power, me community, say
to give bread.
Seven, this guy, poor at
the
charity.
Then go to the road to where you are canteen.
Never.
When I don't take a canteen,
grass can say
I
don't need
them. It will not work.
Any anyone.
So I came back home.
It's a baby.
The case came up.
The assembly in Kwasi Libya.
The man has told the baby the time that I should give him the canteen to bring to his house.
Now, but she said the man accept this and now no ever.
He never materialized.
Now,
never. No, I can't tell. Nothing went there.
Libya, because
I went to the court.
The Kwasi Libya.
And one of my schoolmates was a lawyer, prempe.
Now,
he
was schoolmate. Ona na aye lawyer Ojimami.
I told him everything.
To make ideas.
We went for the case.
The court,
I did not provide any guarantee or money.
My first time, I
tell you, we won the case.
This is
the see, the point I am making is,
yes,
I
can't say.
This is a kind of ruling people who are judged in the world are doing.
The court we are saying, say that you do attend here, and we are in a city.
But when it comes to God,
the very right idea,
the constitution of God is the Ten Commandments.
Yes, you are in Niger, and I say to you.
That is the law.
And not any ground.
Somebody
will also
know Jesus. So if we want to know Jesus,
is it who Jesus is?
Knowing Jesus, if we want to know him,
is it who Jesus is?
We must know what exactly he likes.
And they are who they are.
Ephesians 2:5.
We
come to read it. Let the ideas in Christ be in you.
My yes, more and seven, no, and I won't in the end now.
Look, it saddened my heart when we deliberately go against the structures of God.
And then I read who said, "You didn't the open, you put your open."
It saddened my heart when people try to give excuses. Why? They
disobey
the instructions of God.
Then it's
brethren, until when?
We are not
changed.
Go see the pain in
life cannot be like that all the time for us.
This
is an opportunity time for us.
Wait, I'm
going
to
and follow the instructions of God.
Then they
Jesus magnify the lost.
Yes, you magnify and come on, brethren.
Commandment, the sixth commandment.
But that's what I say, I'm not saying.
That shall not matter.
I say, no.
Jesus magnified that law.
No, obey.
And he said,
I say,
you find it difficult to understand this law.
I say, hey, it's already over to Sunday.
I want to explain that to you.
I say, may church your name.
Hatred comes from the heart.
Or time every, I come.
And I tell all of you today,
I'm catching up with say,
if you hate anybody,
say, what I would be.
If you start thinking evil about somebody,
so you have your money.
That was a kind of magnification Jesus
Christ
was. He spoke about the seventh law.
Okay, that's what I saw.
Do not commit to bring people who are caught in the sin for them to be stoned. They come and restore them. But I'm Jesus. I want to tell you. If you look at the woman,
say,
and you lust for that woman, you have already committed that adultery. Now let me tell you. How many men in this church? Look at the woman walking around. Having a kind of lust in them. The danger here is, only God knows
what's not.
It doesn't come out. However, the same people who are doing that evil inside them, it's not only the men. There are women who also look with the men. Yes. Some of the women will be looking at the men and they will wish something. We are going to be judged. We are going to be judged by the laws. So let us make sure that at least we go by what exactly Jesus is talking
about.
Someone said something that it is good to obey than sacrifice.
Someone said, and yes, sir, we used to see a change, sir, or what for them.
There are many Christians of today who are sacrificing. It is very difficult when you try to obey the laws of God by the flesh. The laws, obeying the laws are very difficult for most of us because we want to obey God's laws by flesh.
But it doesn't
work like that. We need the power of the Holy Spirit. And when you receive the power of the Holy Spirit, it comes natural. And that's what Jesus was talking about. Jesus came to explain that we need to get that love in our hearts. Not in the only days where the book is there, they go open and they see, hey, look. The first commandment I committed, no, not start. Do you have that in mind now?
Now,
know that Jesus that you are worshiping. Indeed, if you love him, abide his commandment. There is something here that's also a bit funny. There is a mainstream Christianity that ignores the inspired New Testament scripture, teaches loving God and one another, that eliminates the law.
I
tell you again, John exposes this kind of teaching errors. John points out the obedience to God's commandment is the very standard which love for God and his children are
measured.
And he said in 1 John chapter 5, verse 2 to 3.
Unquote.
By this standard, we know that we love the children of God. When we love God and keep his commandment, for this is the love of God, that we keep his commandment, and his commandment are not
better.
Jesus Christ taught his followers to obey all his commandments.
Jesus said, "The people in answer, who need the answer?"
Jesus magnified the laws of God and revealed the full spiritual meaning to his followers.
Jesus said, "Now, but who man that you need to be the answer?"
Jesus Christ, as the spiritual leader, made the laws and the commandments of God far binding to his followers.
Jesus said, "Who man who say, 'Hey, dad, dad, bravo,' he said, 'Come on, bravo, bravo,
the laws of God are good."
Jesus said, "Oh, yeah."
The laws of God are good. Indeed, the citizens of God, Christians, if we obey the instructions of God, then peace.
Let us
listen to the word of God. Because the laws of the world will not give us anything. And it's by so many that we can attain salvation.
Say, yes, sir.
I mean, look, those laws that are inept.
Now, in Israel,
come back home. The traditional way of giving the laws for the citizen to follow are not those that are going to give us salvation.
Say, if you know your man,
I mean, some of the laws are so appalling that sometimes when you listen, you just don't want to follow. I told you a story sometimes ago about a guy called
Anani.
There used to be a certain village, and every year there was a fetish priest in that village. And every year, what they do is they try to gather some eggs, and they just put the eggs at just in front of the city or just behind the city to pacify the gods. That is their thinking.
Now, if we are not the law, we are say. Now say the two bar. Now or more any kusia a koku ekono etipi ana four said the other pata and yamia the trend could wash.
I mean they tell all the citizens in that city. Oh, the citizens in that city have to bring egg. If you don't bring egg, you have to bring money. So that you use the money to go and buy eggs.
Many times
they go to do the eggs. Some days they'll go and all the eggs are gone.
No, I'm not saying I've taken it.
So they come and they say, "Oh yes, the gods have taken the eggs." Not knowing there was somebody who was taking the eggs.
No one was doing that. Anna
was taking the eggs all the time.
And then there was Anna
and what fascinated me was that, look, he took the egg, he ate it, nothing happened.
Now when dear, it will be clean that.
A time came. One man decided that he couldn't find out why the eggs are going so fast
like that.
So they picked up all the eggs there. Unknown to Anani. People were spying to see a kind of ghost that were going to take those eggs.
And
deep in the night. With his sack.
Out in the bottom.
Went just at the end of the town.
No, go down now for
all the eggs.
No, the
people on the
side of
the
channel.
Packing the eggs. The man said, Anani. So you are the gods, you are the gods of this town. So it means all the eggs you have been eating it. Do you know what Anani said? Indeed, I need this egg than the gods.
Brethren,
the point I'm trying to make here is there are some laws and regulations which are unnecessary.
Like
we get ourselves into it just because of tradition.
It
will not bring you salvation. But I tell you,
as we catch ourselves,
Jesus lost.
Yes, you ran it.
You disobey.
So who you
are? You're out of the game.
And then now I'm going to
brother, that is a fact.
And okay.
Look, don't go and misunderstood people by saying with love everything's okay. No.
It is my prayer.
That today.
And then
knowing God.
Yehu Emrade.
Knowing Jesus.
Yehu Christ.
Is to follow him. commandments.
Say ye did nonsense.
You can't know Jesus when you don't follow his commandments.
Yeah. Oh, yes, you are. What
may the Almighty God give us understanding. May he give us the grace for me to know the importance of following his commandments. Those that were difficult in the old days, Jesus has come to make it very clear. It is my prayer once again that today we will tend to be a new land.
And
make sure that the commands are
followed.
Bringing the sermon to an end.
God tells us
not
to
have
finished.
Let's get to know the benefits of abiding God's law.
Okay.
In Jeremiah chapter 7, verse
23-29.
When abide the commandments of God.
So
God will be with you always. Hallelujah. In Proverbs, God will be the enemies of your enemies. Hallelujah. In the book of John,
God
will give you eternal life. When you go to Proverbs again, God will give you a prolonged. You will get success in everything that you do. When you go to Genesis, your offspring will be blessed. When you go to Genesis, no one this will attack you. When you go to Deuteronomy, it will go well with you and your children. When you go to Genesis, God will be the enemy for you. Hallelujah.